recollections of mine must get a little tedious, but they're part of my job, apparently. Muse of epic poetry, that's what I'm supposed to be. But from the chores I get lumbered with, you'd think I was PRO to Mount Olympus. Never mind, I suppose somebody has to keep an eye on things and keep all the goings on strictly according to Homer. After all, mythology is mythology. Right, well, let's see. Everything here seems to be in order. Why don't you finish off your shepherd's hay, and then you can all run along.
Keeps. Well, at last the sun is shining, and the flowers all the world dear. nymph of my dreams. But soft, Orpheus, for she is alone. What a bit of luck. I shall reveal my presence by playing a few bars of her favorite melody. Flowers on a shepherd's cottage.
And I never for one moment expect you were squandering that serenade on me. Which one of the many lady friends did you mistake me for?
Does it matter? Anyway, what's the meaning of the harvest festival?
Does that matter either? Can't our mutual indifference will be a matter of mutual indifference?
A case of you go your way, and I'll go mine.
Exactly. And why you're caterwauling to your shepherdesses?
Caterwauling? As a performer on the violin, I am considered to be...
Personally, I'm sick of the sound of the thing. But by all means, scrape it elsewhere to your heart's content. And while you're doing so, if a harmless flirtation happens to come my way...
Harmless?
So far, yes. But under the circumstances, I can't make any promises. Aristides is very fond of me. And speaking for myself...
Don't bother. You've already said it with flowers. Goodness knows what you see in the fellow.
At least he shows me some interest and doesn't spend all his time fiddling. Well, not that sort of fiddling anyway.
There! That's how you feel.
Thank you.
bitter end. A badly bitten, bitter end is what he's liable to come to. If he doesn't watch his step in yonder cornfield.
Cornfield? You mean there's some sort of danger in there for my poor Aristaeus? But how horrid! What could it possibly be?
Don't ask me. Just thought I'd mention it. Well, must get on. I've got pupils waiting. Oh, don't forget to tell your shepherd. Beware of the cornfield.
He's up to something, I shouldn't wonder. And I'd better try and find out what it is. I mean, I can't help my poor Aristaeus get into some sort of... Nathan alive! And I bet I know who put them there. Oh, the wretch! I must find poor Aristaeus at once and warn him of his peril. Oh, Aristaeus, hurry, hurry!
My flocks on hilltop high. You should come up sometime and see us. From morning until night, far away from care and strife, I never cease to delight in the simple
Enjoy that bit of him like an occasional ruri ringdilly for inspiring confidence.
Little do these benighted rustics guess my real name and nature. Oh, how they would tremble at the new, his shirt, his cloak, his butt in disguise, and in their midst stands Pluto, king of Hades. Fortunately, for my deep and deadly designs, they haven't the foggiest. They're as green as our own Arcadian meadows.
Well, nymphs are free, be on your mind, you. I'd love to be alone to meditate on the pleasures of pastoral existence. Orpheus seemed to enjoy the practical joke I suggested to him. If he's done as I've asked, then the fare your Eurydice is as good as mine.
Ah, here she comes now, blissfully unaware.
I'm the only snake in the grass that really matters. I must try and look innocent.
Alas, in vain I have sought everywhere for my lover. And no wonder, he's been here all the time. Oh, Aristides, dear Aristides, I have a message for you. Beware!
Beware? Why?
Take one step in yonder cornfield, and you're a goner!
Dinna worry yourself. This thinna shepherd is bitty, and he'll have deem it a bitty.
No, I tell you, it's crawling 38 serpents in there.
Oh, I say so.
My husband!
Oh, him!
No, but it's true, I've seen them myself.
Dinna worry yourself, Gwen. It's probably some sort of trick he's trying to play us, to get his aim back.
But really, he'll hate it be better than that. In the first place, I'm immune to snake bite.
You are? Why?
Then again, something to do with beekeeping, perhaps. In the second, he hasn't an earthly against true love. I think it he does have kindness.
I'm afraid so.
Afraid, my little shepherdess. Big fit is all to be afraid of. Love always wins in the end. It's the way of the world. It's the same in Olympus come to that.
Or anywhere else.
But that's what they say, but we don't really know, do we?
I did.
How?
Oh, I hear it from the very best authority if they counsel a fennec.
Mortals below, gods up above, equal they love to fall in love. Two worlds apart, though they may be, love throws them both impartially.
Oh, sinking.
Rapidly.
No hope for me at all.
Not in this world, but you've quite a future in a different one with me.
In that case, perhaps I'd better get it over with.
Izzy Wizzy, let's get busy. We shall be on our way in a moment, after you've left a farewell message for your bereaved husband. Only polite, don't you think?
Anything you say.
In that case, leave a message on his pedestal.
What with?
Oh, use this. I promise you, you won't see the right thing, but he will.
Anyone who believes that would believe anything. So I believe anything. Quite mad, of course, but by this point I'm past caring. There, a laugh to do. After all, we are in rather a hurry, aren't we?
Oh, you really see, this is the moment I've been waiting for.
What are you waiting for?
Considering our destination, a little hurly-burly perhaps, to cover our departure.
And you mustn't be flippant about it.
Oh, but Mother, you know jolly well that you really
think. Yes, that's the point. Your private life and your personal feelings have nothing to do with it.
But we simply didn't get on. For both of us, Eurydice and me, this is the best bit of luck.
Oh, it's a terrible blow, and you are heartbroken. You really must try and remember that. Think of your public image.
Who cares about that? I'm a free man again.
Oh, you are nothing of the sort. You're a wronged husband, robbed of a beloved wife by one of the gods.
But that's the beauty of it. Fate is out of my hands. I cannot argue with the gods.
Of course you can, and you must. Pluto is notorious for this sort of thing, and Jupiter will be furious. He'll certainly expect you to lodge a protest.
Me?
How?
We must fly to Mount Olympus immediately.
But good heavens, I don't want to do that. I'd be scared stiff.
Obvious.
Besides, I might get her back again.
That is the object of the exercise.
But I tell you, I don't
put up a show. What would people think? Darling, do try to look a bit bereft. My dears, I suppose you know what's happened. Isn't it awful? Dear Eurydice, my son's precious little wife has been carried off by that demon, Pluto. Oh, the best mythological tradition, of course, but upsetting nevertheless. Naturally, Orpheus, heartbroken. Aren't you, Orpheus?
Oh, yes, naturally.
So again, in the best mythological tradition, I shall escort him to Mount Olympus, where he can face the mighty Jupiter, king of the gods, and with the courage born of his grief, reclaim his beloved. You will do it, won't you?
I don't seem to have any choice, do I?
I must do as I am bid, I see, and duly chase, have chased you rid of thee. I tell you now, she'll think it hateful and ungrateful, my proper freedom to decline, when all the time to suit us fine, she went her way. Thank you.
of fooling me. Venus, do you and this child of yours always have to come home with the milk?
You forget, Pop. Cupid and I do most of our best work on night shifts.
And what about...
And
what about you, Mars? Detained at the War Office, were you?
No, I had no party.
A party? Yes. You tell her to send you home at a more respectable hour, didn't you? Hello, we're one on the strength. Diana, now where's she? Out late or up early?
Up early, of course. Getting groomed to meet Actaeon.
Actaeon? Oh, the hunting fellow.
You know, you meant to do something about him.
I know I did. And I have. It's a pity I didn't get the chance to explain to Diana before she went dashing off. I could have saved her the trouble of waiting about for him. Come on, there's still time. What do you plan to go chasing today? Claudish mortals on earth are beginning to talk. It's a matter of prestige. Oh. We have to keep up appearance.
Oh, yes. You set such a good example, don't you?
What's all this and using up your tricks against mother?
Certainly not, my lord. How could you suggest such a thing? And don't look me. Not in front of the children, anyway. It undermines my authority. Venus, Vulcan, I trust that you two have... Settled your romantic difficulties, eh?
Yes, I think so. Have we not?
You great catty-headed me!
Oh well, at least they're on speaking terms again. That's something, I suppose. I don't know. I think I'll have to start a clean-up Olympic campaign. Too many goings-on. Too much falling out. not to mention sleeping sicko, don't any of you realize that we are supposed to set the moral tone of the universe?
Silence!
What's got into you lot this morning anyway?
Well, if you really want to know, we're pretty fed up of all this preaching. From you of all people.
You what?
And a dip round off too, everlastingly stuck up here.
Silence! Venus, can you not control this precocious child of yours?
She's quite right, Papa. The Olympian way of life sounds all very fine, but does get tedious. And you've been getting very bossy lately. When I think of my poor auntie, dirty big teeth and all shiny.
Oh, now don't start all that rot again.
What we need is a break, a holiday,
and a change of diet if ever anybody would say it's ambrosia.
Oh, what gets me is all this instant litter. Yes. Not my cup of tea at all.
Talk about an ungrateful lot. Don't any of you realize we are the most affluent society in existence. If you knew what with poll tax and everything else, what these wretched mortals on earth have to put up with.
Might be back by now.
So he should, my love, so he should. Don't you worry. Now, he's a good lad, he's Mercury. He gets on with the job, never complains.
Oh, it's all very well for him flitting about all over the place just as he pleases.
Not stuck in a smelly forge like
meat, slaving
over a hot anvil.
All he has to do is nod around and pick up a dozen. Call that one!
Somebody has to keep us in touch. Look, if we didn't know what was going on, how could we do anything about it?
Well, let's hope this time it brings some really interesting news to the world. I should see God's guy would be a gossip.
Here he goes. Come on, Mark. Hail, King Olympus, ruler of the elements.
All right, lad. You can cut out the titles. It's sounding a bit hollow this morning. Now then, anything to report?
Nothing cataclysmic, mighty Jupiter. But on Earth is one rather intriguing matrimonial situation. It's causing quite a stir among the natives.
Nice and spicy, eh?
Well, it depends what you mean by nice. A certain young lady of Thebes.
What's this? The limerick?
Oh, you quiet, you be let me tell what will happen. Can't you see what all I've got?
All of what?
Oh, I'm lucky. This young lady of Thebes, is she attractive?
She's beautiful as a goddess by all accounts. My name is Eurydice. I'm married woman.
Who's the lucky fella?
Orpheus, the professor of music.
What? Calliope, son,
the same.
But what about Eurydice? What's happened to her?
She's left her husband, lured away by another.
So what? It happens all the time, especially amongst the mortals. Now, knowing Calliope, she'll make an epic to do about it. But apart from that, what's so intriguing about Orpheus's wife running off with another man?
Not another man, sire. True, he made love through the guise of a shepherd, but before he vanished with her into thin air, he revealed himself as one of the gods.
You what? Oh, that's different. Very different. What one of the gods, eh? Somebody has got some explaining to do.
Somebody certainly has, Jupiter!
Hey, what?
Will you have enough to chitting any monster, you?
Certainly not, my love. How could you suggest such a thing? I have not been down to Earth for months.
But King Pluto has. On a long vacation, sampling a simple life, he should return to Hades with a traveling companion,
a lady from Earth. And beautiful?
According to what I heard, an absolute smasher.
That slide of Pluto's been at it again. Shame on you, my dear, accusing me.
It seems for once I've known you, my darling. Can you ever forgive me?
There, we'll say no more about it. But I shall certainly have strong words to say to that Pluto. This sort of thing isn't good enough when it comes to amorous entanglements with mortals. All right. But we can keep up appearances, can't we? That's a matter of prestige, you know. Mercury-like. Look, I know you're tired and you should be off duty, but you're feeling in pretty good fettle. Good lad. Look, do me a favor. Unit down to Hades, present my compliments to King Pluto, and tell him I wish to have words with him. Immediately, bring him back with you. He shall see what it means to blot the copybook of the gods. Right? On your marks, lad.
Now, let's see if you can break your Olympic record. On your marks, get set, go! You sound as though you need what bit you've got left. Oh, and congratulations, you've knocked 3.5 seconds off his own. Now then, Merc, did you get Pluto?
You wait, Your Majesty's pleasure. A bit puffed, but quite cheerful.
We'll soon fix that.
Oh, and sire, I think you can expect more visitors.
What do you mean, more visitors?
There's a balloon on its way from Earth with a navigator and two
customers. Balloon? A balloon? What do they think this is? Open day or something? People cannot just drop in. Who are they? What do they want?
Stop getting in a flat, Droopy. There's such an earth, said Murphy. Well, make a change whoever they are.
Did you get me to visit them? What do they like?
Men?
Women?
No.
Pretty?
One's a chap with a violin by name of Orpheus.
Oh, the wrong husband.
The other's a lady.
Don't tell us. He's outraged, Mama. Calliope! Oh, now, that's falling. I shall have to do something. Mercury, lad, get Pluto quick. No, just a minute. Tell His Majesty the King of Hades that I am now ready to receive him in audience. Okay, come on, you lot, off you go. Affairs of state.
Oh, but Duke, we want to see the barn.
Ah, and all about Pluto carrying all the silence. I shall do with this matter. My dear Jupiter, and you. My dear chap, how nice it is to see you again. Ah, the incomparable Juno, plus Lady of Olympus, radiant as ever.
Don't be
sure to no, honestly, I was delighted to get your invitation. It really is a pleasure to be in Olympus again. What a lovely place you have here, you lucky dainties. Oh, how I envy you, sporting eternally in Elysian groves, skies forever blue. Not a hint of sulfur and balmy air. At your command, the music of Apollo's lyre, soothing as the queen of doves, with the gracious to dance, light as death, with the bright and fitting
clouds. Wait. We should have had you write the travel brochure. Now listen to me. This is not a social occasion, you know.
No.
No.
But don't kid yourself, you're in a fight that you've been fetched.
Oh, have I now? Do we have some business to discuss?
We do. Some monkey business. Where exactly have you been spending your time?
Oh, what? In the gloomy vaults of Hades!
Gloomy! I like that! From what I'm hearing!
All right. Have you, by any chance, been down to Earth, incognito, sampling the pleasures of country life?
Country life? Can you imagine me with straw in my hair playing the recorder?
In between times, yes.
Oh, come on now, what's this really all about?
About a pretty embarrassing bit of barefaced robbery. Somebody has dropped a king-sized clanger. Now then, would you know anything about it?
Who be?
Yes, you.
Pardon me.
Who else? Or as I hear tell, you've been up to your tricks. And you know darn well that you put us in a fix.
Me, I'm curious. Would you please state the reason why you're suddenly annoyed with me? You see, I have no idea what it can be.
You're trying to
deceive, but that's a very about that nymph you have stolen away. And in such an infamous way led astray.
Who, me?
Yes, you.
Why me?
Why not?
All right, so what let be done with me, Tess? If I'm in a spot, I reserve my defects.
Quite untamable.
And incurable. If I have young ladies in Hades among the visitors, since when has that been any concern of yours?
Let us walk in something.
Why you feel so sore isn't yet very plain. It's been done before, it'll be done again.
Before?
Often.
By who?
Yes, who?
Shall I tell you about the fairy bird? The bird, 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 the bird,
get you into such a scrape. Now, think of the discussions, all the repercussions. How can I escape?
Between me and you, old boy, I do have a bit of a time of it here, you know, what with looking after the kids all night and nag from the wife all day. You know, you have a far better time of it. My trouble is, I have to be so high-minded all the time.
Officially.
Exactly. Well, we've got to move. Tell me about this music. Tell you the truth, I wouldn't mind judging her for myself, if only I could think of a way to...
I don't wish to interrupt your train of thought, but doesn't the shop floor meeting seem to be getting rather out of hand?
No, it does. Don't worry, I'll go solve it.
You can't see this one right now! You never find the problem! I'll stand up! Everybody, see you all differently!
What is it? What a family!
Thank you.
darling, for the Olympic Choral Society for that swinging rendition of the Red Flag by Sir Edward Elgar. Now listen, you lot! How dare you turn against me, your king! Your papa.
Oh, we did warn you. You will treat us like children.
I reserve my defense. The matter is still covered judicially.
Which means it's none of your business.
Oh, what school's he to preach anyway?
Talk about pot calling kettle black.
Hey, who said that?
Son.
Delish.
Easily.
To think a daughter of mine.
But not that mine, if you remember.
Now, don't you start.
We just don't think the past of your record. You meant business.
My record, the best of husbands, the kindest of fathers.
Oh, don't give us that. We know lots of stories about you, don't we?
One more. We've
made
up a song about you. Would you like to hear it?
Certainly not. If you've made it up, I'm sure it's libelous, treasonable, and in very poor taste.
How dare you make up a new song about your poor father?
Oh, now don't take it so seriously, dear lady. You have a very talented family. If they made up a song, it's bound to be very amusing. I'd certainly like to hear it.
You would.
And surely, mighty Jove, greatest patron of mirth in the universe, chairman of the B-side choristers, can take a joke.
Of course I can. And don't you dare say I can't. Go on then. Go on, the lot of you. Sing your stupid song if you want to. I've got another appointment.
Oh, no, you haven't.
You'll stay and listen. Whenever Jove hears of duty, the pretty girl his eye escapes. And to increase some eager beauty, he'll take a horse from lifeless days. Ha, ha, ha! They were all pre-married.
Oh, if they were, I wouldn't believe it. I'm on my dad.
time. Ah, you see. You see, at least one of the family keeps his mind on his job and shows a little bit of respect. Good lad, what is it?
Ah, the other visitors, sir, they've arrived.
They have? Oh, they
haven't been there yet. Oh, they've arrived, have they? You know who they are.
I jest, I noticed them in the way up here.
Oh, how jolly clever of them. You know what they're here about?
Yes, most unfortunate.
You can say that again.
Most unfortunate.
Listen, you lot. Listen, if we are going to get out of this predicament with any prestige left at all, we've got to put up a show, understand? We've got to pull together for once. Right, come on now. I think I'll be on the throne. Come on, love. Venus, Cupid, you, on the left. Mars, Vulcan, come on, everyone, round the throne. Helmet on. Look as imposing as possible. Right there, how does that look like?
Magnificent, a truly Olympian picture.
Makes a pretty good family portrait.
Oh, very effective, sir. Most impressive.
I'll tell you what, anybody
take it? Your guests are waiting.
All right, lad, don't just stand there. Show them in.
Thank you. Thank you.
better than a jailer. Quite bats too, I'm sure of it. Sugar, here he comes now, old nightmare himself.
Love the the face and form that haunts me in my dreams. Your ladyship had?
No, my ladyship did not.
Oh, I wish you had, that you would have wanted something and I could have been of service. Whenever I hear the bell, I rush to do your ladyship's bidding. Whenever I don't hear it, I feel a forlorn and useless creature. Is it at all possible that your ladyship might ring the bell sometime?
Well, how on earth can I tell?
Oh, but you're not on earth. Didn't you know?
Of course I know. How in Hades could I help knowing?
Any sign of King
Pluto? No, he is not back yet from whatever it is he said he was going to.
And you can't think where that could be?
No, he did tell me, but it's gone completely. You see, I'm addicted to the waters of the river Lethe. They make you forget everything. When the master dashed off, I went on a real binge, and I've forgotten everything he said.
Well, that's a great help.
But then, when I saw you here, looking all exquisitely beautiful as ever, it suddenly did bring it back to me that you shouldn't be out here, you know, by rights.
By rights? What right has he to cage me out here when he's gallivanting off somewhere?
Alas, poor lady, alas.
Now,
no, it's just the way I am here. It's my lowly status, I suppose. I never reckoned on being a servant in afterlife. Would you like to know what I was before?
Not particularly. Oh, but do tell me. I can see you going to anyway. Let us meet the little pass of time. Lovely lady, don't be hard on me. A moment ago, I was thinking I'd welcome any distractions. But this is ridiculous. Would you please go away now and leave me to enjoy my boredom in peace?
Can it be you are as cruel as you are beautiful, unable to spare even one kindly word for a poor, lonely ghost?
Well, that was quite dreadful. Here, let's float somebody. Where's this? That's my one, it's a fine one. I must say.
Oh, his master's voice, thank goodness for that.
Think, Pluto, he's home again. You shouldn't be out here, you know, by rights. You shouldn't be out here, you know, by rights.
Oh, very well. But I'll get me all back and it's perishing majesty before long. You see if I don't.
Ah, Styx, quick, how about your Odyssey?
On the lock and key, naturally, your honor.
Very Styx. Right, good. Now listen, we have visitors, lots of visitors. The entire Olympic team with King Jupiter himself as captain. I rushed on ahead to give you the tip to be very discreet about your nymph. Take a cue from me, got it?
Got it.
Here's the old boy now. This way, O king, welcome to Hades.
Welcome, welcome indeed. You call this a welcome? I had to bring the family through your infernal portals myself. We didn't see you for dust.
I rushed on ahead to be ready to receive your majesty. Talking of dust, you're looking a bit travel soiled. Give the king of gods a brush down.
Very, very nether your regions, aren't they?
Well, you know, home is where the heart is. Albeit ever so humble, there's no place like Hades.
Certainly isn't. Hey, you, steady on with that thing.
I hope the boys and girls will enjoy it too. Where are they, by the way?
I don't know. I thought they were right behind. Here's a couple of them now. Where's the rest of the party?
They've been taken on a conducted tour, sire.
By one of the locals. Must be the oldest inhabitant by the look of them.
That'll be chaos, I expect.
We thought so too, so we skipped it. Chaos? That doddering old dead. He must be a million if he's a knight. You! Steady on! Who is this berserk creature?
Styx, my valet and valued factotum.
Desist! Nix Styx. Your valued factotum, eh?
Yes, you know, he shares all my little secrets.
All? Then, he knows.
Knows what?
That you're in trouble, of course, and the reason why.
Now, I haven't explained it to you, well, not in so many words.
When the master is in trouble, there is only one reason. A woman.
He's right, you know. I think Nemesis must have had a one-track mind.
Whenever any man's ejected, he's able to brood and hold the side. As if for same thing he expected, like you and me, technically there can be but one reason why.
Battleman can never win.
If your wings don't cast, there's no mystery. The reason's always clear. My hero claim as any lover. Maybe him behaving like a man. And you know who to keep an eye on. Like a girl is always
in a fix, you will find that the ladies do not do a trick.
And again, you may guess, be it great, be it small, there's a dame you can guess who's the cause of it all.
Any time, any place, when a man's on the mat, there's a girl in the case, it's as simple as that.
And they all who confess is the trouble and strife. If the girl in the case, you can tell somebody's quite
a very sad, but it's true, when a man's with a chap, then you know what to do. Simply shush it about.
So when you see the clue why a man's in a jam, then you know what to do. Simply shush it about.
Then you know the cause of Olympus at all.
What a last friend of girls might suppose of us all. If they want to avoid a scientific correct sucker, will be left with a sense of the sex.
Every hero and king seems to be in a rut.
Making love is the thing that we do nothing but. So when you're what you are, and when I'm what I am,
then the best rule I thought will be shell shade up. Yes, the best rule I thought will be Someone, sire?
Oh, yes, I am. And you know jolly well who? A certain nymph by name of Eurydice. Yes, formerly the property of a certain Orpheus. Now, I know that she's here somewhere, and I intend to find her. Oh, I see you have a key. And it would appear to fit that door. What room's that?
This is the junk room, yes. This is where we keep the lumber. And I'll see if I can locate the lady you mentioned and inform her that if she's agreeable, you'd like to meet her. But first, I must arrange for some small celebrations to mark Your Majesty's visit. Naturally, I intend that you and your party should be right royally entertained, and my resident troop of the county shall have to be brief. Come, Styx, we have much to attend to. Do make yourself at home, sire, if you'll excuse us.
A bit upon himself, that's what he's getting. He'd better watch out, or there'll be some thunderbolts flying there. Now, I still think that in there would be the obvious place to keep us. And you can't believe a word of what he says. The lumber, he says. Sounds the sort of junk I wouldn't mind being lumbered with.
Settling
wherever you please.
Oh, The notion has distinct possibilities.
How do I contact the lady?
Haven't you heard that love laughs at locksmiths?
Oh, I say, what a cracker.
No flies on her. Yet.
Older, I fancy she'll learn quite a lot. From a fly sort of fly, though as yet all he does is go buzz, 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 buzz. Buzz, 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 buzz.
More eager than I thought.
more worthy of your favors than a blithering bluebottle. And somebody much more worthy of reciprocating them. Behold!
Well, that was quite some trip.
Yes, wasn't it?
One moment, a frolicsome fly. And the next, a strong, handsome man.
Strong, yes. Handsome, indubitably. But man, no.
No? Then what?
Ha-ha! Jove, mighty Jove, better known as Jupiter for short. I'm on a short stay here from Olympus. Exactly. The ruler of the elements, the hurler of thunderbolts, the same.
Oh my God!
Thank you.
and I had a sort of understanding.
Maybe, maybe not.
But you really see, it's all fixed. I'm rescuing you from the clutches of Pluto and taking you back to Olympus with me.
Oh, you really beautiful, charming.
If Juno catches you, she'll have hysterics again.
That being the case, I shall leave her down here with you.
Oh, yeah? The only person you leave down with you permanently is your Eurydice.
Oh, yeah. If you really want to know, she's fed up to the back teeth of you, neglecting her the way you do.
It's true. I've been busy since she's been here, but I have my plans for her.
We'll see about that. I tell you what, she shall choose between us. And in my official capacity of protector of omnipotence trainings, I shall see to it that she chooses.
Come, let us not wrangle in public. Remember, this is a party in your honor. And I think it's time for you to leave the dancing. Listen, everybody. Mighty Jupiter decrees, on with the dance. And leave us in our revels.
Come on, me, leave the dancing.
Oh, I think you should, you know, for the look of the thing. Etiquette and all that.
Etiquette? Here?
But of course, even in the underworld we have our moments of refinement, as you shall see.
If I had my way, so-called etiquette I would forget.
As it is, you must stay and sing this minuet.
Thank you. Calliope
in Orpheus? I've forgotten all about them.
So am I.
I'm afraid so. I've managed to stall them so far, pending negotiations. Now I guess I shall have to tell them something.
Yes, but what?
To obey your promise, my darling, send poor Eunice to be back for a laughing husband.
Yes, yes, my dear,
I don't want to go back.
Don't you worry, my dear. Papa Jove will fix everything.
How?
I'll think of something.
Surely it doesn't need much thinking about.
Very well then. Faithful to my word, I hereby restore you to your loving wife. One condition. You shall go your way. Eurydice will follow you. But should you look back, even for a moment, you lose her forever.
You cheated!
Right. You understand me?
Yes. I've to lead on, but not back.
Correct. You've been warned. Off you go then.
Book season continues with Roy Minton's challenging and disturbing account of life in a borstal, where new arrivals are drawn into the power play and uncompromising violence of the institution. Scum.
Tonight's film in the Alan Clark season is Scum.